Philippine House lawmaker Pantaleon Alvarez might face charges following his call to state forces to turn their back on the Marcos administration. That's according to a former head of the Integrated Bar of the Philippines. The former House Speaker urged the military and police to withdraw their support for President Marcos so he will be forced to step down. This as he expressed concern Marcos's stance on the West Philippine Sea issue may lead to a war with China.
Kung itignan, parang seditious nga yan, ano? Kaya lang, finalify niya kasi ito sa mga adjectives eh, para hindi mapasama dun sa loob ng inciting to sedition.
Following Alvarez's call, the armed forces and the PNP reaffirmed their loyalty to the Constitution. They vow to uphold their mandate of protecting the Filipino people regardless of who's in power. President Marcos claimed he is in good terms with Vice President Sara Duterte. This as for his relationship with the rest of the Duterte clan. The president admits it's a bit complicated. Pia Gutierrez returns with his report.
It's complicated. That's how President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. describes his relationship right now with the Duterte clan, as the Philippine leader and his predecessor, former President Rodrigo Duterte, continue to clash on various national issues from charter change to the West Philippine Sea.
It's complicated.
Okay.
All right. It's complicated, but if you ask about the one, of course, that I have the most contact with is Inday Sara, and how we were with each other during the campaign, after the election, it hasn't really changed.
But despite a recent falling out with the Dutertes, the president, during a forum of the Foreign Correspondents Association of the Philippines, says his administration remains firm that it will not hand over Duterte to the International Criminal Court. This as he insists that the ICC does not have jurisdiction over the Philippines.
We don't recognize the warrant that they will send to us.
So that's a no?
That's a no. It is the rule of ICC that they come in when there is no judiciary. They come in when there is no police force. We have a judiciary. The Chief Justice, the former Chief Justice, is sitting right here. He will explain to you how healthy and robust and active the judiciary is. The police force, I think, the same thing.
When asked about his family's ill-gotten wealth, the president says that he's leaving it to his lawyers to handle these cases, including the contested $40 million Arelma asset of the Marcoses.
It's hard for me to answer. I really haven't looked at it in years. And I would advise you to talk to the lawyers that are handling it, because I'm not being specious or anything like that. Matagal ko nang hindi narinig yung pangalan na Arelma. The previous cases, the cases that were filed post-1986, I have not touched. I have nothing. It would be highly improper for me to involve myself in that. Besides, I don't have the time to do it, so I leave it to the lawyers.
As to whether the president will apologize to victims of atrocities committed under his father's martial rule, Marcos Jr. says it is not his duty as Philippine leader to be involved, adding that it is a personal matter for the Marcos family.
But you are a member of the Marcos family.
Definitely, but it's more, my role as president is more important right now than my role as a member of the Marcos family. So I take that, that's my first priority.
According to the data of Amnesty International, over 100,000 Filipinos were killed, imprisoned, or tortured under the martial law regime of the president's late father, President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.
President Marcos believes China is not making up the supposed gentleman's agreement involving his predecessor, former President Rodrigo Duterte. China's insisted Manila reneged on some of its promises, including towing away the rusting BRP Sierra Madre, as well as maintaining the status quo in Ayungin Shoal. Marcos says Duterte should have informed him of the secret deal. He adds the lack of evidence stops Duterte from being held liable for his actions.
Why did you keep it secret? Why is there not one single document that contains that agreement? Why is there not one shred of evidence that can show that this agreement exists? Why, when we the transition period between the previous administration to this administration, did no one mention a secret agreement? These are very simple questions, but I'm finding a great deal of difficulty finding answers for them, because I hear one thing and another thing and another thing and another thing. It's all very. Maraming palusot. In other words, I don't know how to translate that in English, but maraming palusot.